Hello, my name is Andrew Boschert. I'm currently an undergraduate student in animal science at Iowa State University. This summer, I'm an intern with Kansas State University's Applied Swine Nutrition Program, where I'm focusing on swine nutrition research that is related to the National Pork Board-funded Pig Survivability Research Grant. In this video, I will be discussing the importance of providing injectable iron to newborn piglets and how injectable iron affects piglet survivability. This review was a part of the Improving Pig Survivability Project, a five-year multidisciplinary project aimed at reducing mortality in the U.S. swine industry. You can learn more about the Improving Pig Survivability Project at www.piglivability.org. As swine producers, we know that it is necessary to provide injectable iron to piglets after birth. The reason that supplemental iron is necessary for piglets is that piglets are born with low iron reserves. Additionally, there is not enough iron that is passed to the piglets through the sow's colostrum and milk during the lactation period to support the rapid growth of the piglet. Several years ago, the impact of not providing a supplemental iron injection may not have had such a large impact on production and growth for the piglet because piglets often had exposure to soil as a source of iron. Research has shown that piglets that did not receive an iron injection after birth were approximately 17 pounds lighter at the first marketing event compared to piglets receiving a 200 milligram injection of iron after birth. A study conducted in 2015 showed the impact of piglet size at weaning on serum iron concentrations. Pigs that were identified as large at weaning had decreased serum iron levels compared to those pigs that were identified as medium or small at weaning. Similarly, in an earlier study that was conducted by Joliffe and Mahan in 2011, as weaning weight increased, hemoglobin levels decreased. This study also showed that as weaning weight increased, hematocrit levels decreased. Lower levels of hemoglobin and hematocrit are indicative of lower serum iron concentration. Therefore, faster growing pigs are prone to lower levels of serum iron, which can lead to anemia. An intramuscular injection of iron in the neck region of the piglet is the most common method to provide piglets with iron within a week after birth. Those piglets that receive an iron injection are able to retain the iron for future use. Two common sources of injectable iron in today's swine industry are iron dextrin and galactosidase. On the right is a diagram showing the proper site of injection. The practice of giving iron orally is a method to increase the body level of iron, but has limited efficacy as a portion of the iron is not absorbed and is excreted in feces. Also, the oral iron dose has the potential to disrupt the pig's digestive tract. Oral iron must be given within the first 6 hours after farrowing, which creates an extremely short window for supplementation. A common question is, how much injectable iron is needed? No exact level has been deemed ideal for all piglets, but a single dose of 150 to 200 milligrams of injectable iron is sufficient to support growth. As we dive deeper into this fundamental question, a study conducted by Williams and others in 2020 showed that injecting piglets with 100 milligrams of iron is sufficient for adequate growth in the pre-weaning stages, but injecting piglets with 200 milligrams of iron was needed to maximize post-weaning gain, feed intake, and blood iron status. Another question that is brought up within this topic is, should I provide a second iron injection to piglets? From a biological perspective, the answer is no. The evidence is very weak to show a measurable benefit of providing two full or partial doses of injectable iron during the suckling stage prior to weaning. Supplementing with a second iron injection can improve blood iron status, but the impact on growth is variable with often no observed benefit to growth. Some producers choose to provide the second iron injection to assure all piglets have received at least one iron dose prior to weaning, or that those piglets did not get missed during litter processing. The graph depicted on the slide shows the effect of iron injection dosage on ending nursery weight. Those dosages were either none or 50, 100, 150, or 200 milligrams of iron in a single injection on day 3 of age, or 200 milligrams on day 3 and 100 milligrams on day 10 of age. Injecting piglets with 200 milligrams of iron was sufficient for adequate growth in the pre-weaning stages. However, 200 milligrams of injected iron was needed to maximize post-weaning gain, feed intake, and blood iron status. Pigs that did not receive injectable iron were 7.8 pounds lighter at the end of the nursery compared to pigs that received a single iron injection of 200 milligrams on day 3. Common production practices within the swine industry show that iron injections are generally given at first litter processing, which can be from day 1 to day 5 after birth. As to the exact day in which an iron injection should be administered, research data is not consistent. Providing the iron injection at any time during the period of day 1 to day 5 after birth should not cause noticeable changes in subsequent piglet growth and body iron status. However, delayed iron injection after 8 days of birth may cause reduced growth and development of anemia prior to the iron injection. More on this question will be discussed in the coming slides. This graph demonstrates the effect of piglet iron injection timing, with injections occurring on day 1, 3, 5, 7, or both day 1 and day 12 of age, or no iron injection given on pig market weight. The pigs with the heaviest body weight at the time of the first marketing event were pigs that received 200 milligrams of iron one day after birth. Those pigs, on average, weighed 276.7 pounds at the time of the first marketing event, with pigs provided iron on day 3 or 5 having similar market weight. This research shows that the piglets that did not receive an iron injection were significantly lighter at the first marketing event. Additionally, we see a decrease of 3.3 pounds in market weight in pigs that were given a 200 milligram injection of iron 7 days after birth, compared to those pigs that were given a 200 milligram dose of iron 1 day after birth. Will an iron injection affect pig survivability? The answer is yes. Anemia can compromise the immune system's ability to fight off infection. A pig's compromised immune system, not being able to fight off an infection, can lead to mortality. Pigs that do not receive an iron injection can develop various lesions that can result in death. Although not consistent in all research trials, providing an iron injection to piglets post-farrowing has been shown to reduce mortality. Growth performance and blood iron status are significantly decreased from anemia caused by a deficient iron body status, but pig mortality is not always increased. So what does this mean? There is still a lot of information that is unknown on causes of mortality, which warrants more further research to be conducted within the topic of iron supplementation via injectable iron to newborn piglets. We know that the impact of factors influencing mortality will differ depending on the production setting. Ensuring all pigs receive injectable iron by day 5 after birth helps pigs get off to a great start. Here are the key literature citations that I used to help make this video. Thank you to the Applied Swine Nutrition team, Kansas State University, for all of their help throughout the process of creating this video. Thank you for listening to this video on the importance of providing injectable iron to newborn piglets. Please check the website for the Improving Pig Survivability Project at www.piglivability.org for more information about projects and resources aimed at reducing mortality in the U.S. swine industry.